some.
Thank you.
We had been at Cardiff for several hours when I received a radio message from Hale. He told me he was in London, and he asked if snow was normal for July. He described a tower in the middle of London, one far bigger than that which they had found in Somerset, and with power conduits emerging in all directions. He said, "If we destroy the tower, we destroy the Chimera." For all I knew, Hale was completely mad. And even if what he was saying was true, we had no idea how to destroy the tower. But there was one new factor working in our favor. I had been able to contact the Americans, and they had joined forces with us in Cardiff. I decided to gamble that Hale was right. I convinced the Americans to help launch a full assault on the tower. We were bringing everything we had to London. I was counting on Hale to clear out a landing zone. If he couldn't take out the stalkers, the mission would be over before it began.
I'm outside. Where are you?
Right. We see you now. Be advised, Sergeant. We're coming in heavy and a little low.
Thank you.
forces arrived in London nearly unscathed. It was hard not to stare in awe at the tower. We had only fled London 6 months earlier, and now it was almost unrecognizable. The whole city was covered in snow. I knew the Chimera thrived in cold weather, but it was hard to fathom how they might actually be altering the climate itself. The power conduits, the snow, and the tower had to be related in some way. There was no time to think about it. Their armies were already guarding the tower, and more would be coming. We set the tanks up in assault formation and started across Tower Bridge. The last tanks were crossing the bridge when we saw Goliaths approaching from behind. We had to destroy the bridge before they caught up to our tanks. Hale and a few other soldiers took up defensive positions while the charges were being set.